You're well aware that it'll take time to get to that level, but at the same time, Bob Arum seems in real kind of, he really admires your ambition when you talk about the likes of Lomachenko. Do you get that impression off Arum that he likes you talking about the end of your career and the biggest of the big fights that could potentially come your way?
Yeah, I think so. You know, I think in this game, you need to know what you want to do and you need to know who you want to face. You want to see, you want to face the best fighters, and I believe Lomachenko is probably number one, number two pound for pound at the minute, and I can see myself facing him in the future. I'm beating him in the future, but at the minute he's still a few leagues ahead of me. So you know, I've got some catching up to do, but I believe give me a little bit of time and I'll be there. And I know Bob and stuff, they love that. They love hearing that stuff, and you know they see it as, you know, this is a kid who's trying to reach for the stars, and we'll have his back the whole way, and it's great to have a promoter and a team around me who want to push my ambition and want to push my drive.
Yeah, I think Arum actually compared your ambition to Floyd Mayweather at the start of his career, that he wasn't exactly calling out the big names, but he was certainly mentioning them, and he made it quite clear how high his ceiling and how big his ambitions really were.
Yeah, that's the main thing. If you want to be a great fighter and go down as a great in history, you have to have that type of ambition. And you can't just put it on. I think it has to be insane to even say or mention the type of things that you're going to mention.
You obviously saw the development and evolution of Carl Frampton from somebody who was very well regarded to somebody who goes on and becomes a world champion. But it took a long time, and people were like, "Oh, they're taking ages to get there." But ultimately, that was the right thing for him in terms of getting to this level. So you desperately need patience. While we're all kind of going, "Is it 18 months? Do you think you'll get a world title fight?"
Well, listen, it's a different circumstance with me than Carl. You know, I'm coming off a great amateur pedigree, you know, two Olympic Games, amateur world champion, and, you know, numerous other titles. Carl didn't really have as much. He had a good amateur background, but he didn't have the major medals, and, you know, he didn't do the two Olympic Games. He turned young as well. I think he turned around 22, 23, so it's different. Me and Carl are different, and I think for me, I think I could have a world title shot within under 15 fights anyway.
Right. Okay. So that's 2 years really, if you're fighting at the rate that you're fighting at the minute, because there is that trend, especially in the division. Like obviously, Lomachenko and Rigondo again had two Olympic Games at least behind both of them, and we have seen people get fast-tracked as well, so it wouldn't be ridiculous to have a world title fight around fights 13, 14 or 15.
It wouldn't be ridiculous to have it even 11 or 12, you know what I mean? It's that possible at the minute, and next year, it's all about next year and how everything goes next year. It's depending on what way we move, what fights we take, and you know, that's why I wanted to be at rounds next, is because I do, towards the end of the year, I want to be there or thereabouts, you know, for the world titles. And I feel if I can go 8 next and do maybe 2 or 3 8s this year, and then maybe up to a 10, and you know, hopefully by the end of the year even a 12, I feel I'll be there or thereabouts. And you know, I'm with the best team in the business, with Top Rank, and you know, it's very, very possible. And I feel if we get the right opponents at the right times next year, we're going to be in the driving seat for coming into 2019.